Let's take a look at the atomic structure for silicon, that's SI, on the periodic table. And we'll use a Bohr diagram, also called a Bohr model here, to help us visualize that. So for silicon, we can see that the atomic number is 14. And the atomic number, that's equal to the number of protons. So we have an atomic number of 14. That means we have 14 protons in the nucleus here of the silicon atom. Because this is a neutral element, all of the elements on the periodic table, they're listed as neutral elements. The number of protons is going to equal the number of electrons. So we'll take the electrons for silicon here and we'll distribute them around the nucleus. We have 14 electrons. We'll put them in these energy levels here. Let's look at the periodic table to help us do that. So we have 14 total electrons. We'll go to the first energy level. This is the first period on the periodic table. We have 1, 2 electrons. And we'll put those right here in the first energy level. There they are, right there. But this energy level is full. So now we have to go to the second energy level. That's the second period. That holds 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we put 8 of these electrons here in the second energy level. And now we've used 2 plus 8, we've used 10 electrons. Remember, we only have 14. So we go to the third energy level here, the third period. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is where Si is, silicon, on the periodic table. So we put those 4 electrons in the highest energy level here, the third energy level. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the Bohr model for the silicon atom. These electrons in the highest energy level, the third energy level here, these are called valence electrons, and they're important. These are the ones that are involved in chemical bonding. If you need help with the electron configuration or figuring out the number of neutrons for silicon, there's a link at the end of this video. This is Dr. B with the Bohr diagram or Bohr model for the silicon atom, SI. Thanks for watching.